the cap.
This is the way I live. Billboard still pushing big bills. I stay my money lay low and chill. Don't need to work hard, that's the way I feel. I feel like this is the way I live. Billboard still pushing big bills.
And Tio around this motherfucker, man.
Y'all know what's going on, man. It's your boy Hollywood Ree. And
it's your boy motherfucking YCM Mac in this bitch.
And it's the No Cap TV show, man. We appreciate y'all for tuning in. Please like, comment, subscribe. And like I said, man, we pushing this content out for y'all. So we appreciate all y'all, man. Let's get it.
All that shit, you understand me? Hey, man, I want to jump right into that shit. Hey, did you see motherfucking Draymond Green?
Man.
Choke up the nigga.
Man,
what's
put
the name?
Rui?
Gooman, whatever the nigga name is.
Whatever the nigga name
Guzman.
Is. He did that, man. But it's crazy because everybody knows Draymond Green.
Call
like
for
he,
your mom.
Call for your mom. He licked that nigga head. But how y'all gonna come at Draymond Green, man? Like, he was standing on business for his man. Y'all gotta think, them a bunch of light skinned ass niggas.
Hey, and it started off with Clay Thompson.
That's what I'm saying. That's a team of light skinned man.
It is.
Draymond Green is the only dark skinned nigga on the team. So, the fact that he had to, you know,
that nigga's
he
wild,
had to
bro.
Protect him. You know what I'm saying?
I'm talking about.
You know what I'm saying?
He grabbed that man. That man didn't even do nothing.
Man, exactly. No, he
nigga,
did do something.
The nigga
though.
Was like.
No, he did do something, though. Because the dude, they got in touch. It was Clay and the dude.
And Rudy.
And dude, Rudy, boy. But then, like they say, he was supposed to grab his own teammate.
Yeah,
boy,
he grabbed Clay.
He grabbed Clay ass.
And so, that nigga came off the back.
Yeah, grabbed his ass quick. So y'all definitely can't be mad at Draymond Green because he definitely standing no business. So I mean, he got his little game suspension, but it's cool.
Did
like,
they win
he,
that
I
game?
Like he, I don't know if he. I don't know. But that's besides the point. It don't even matter.
They better have won that game. But, choke that nigga out like that, nigga.
What the fuck?
That's crazy. Another thing too. Did you see about the Boosie brother, bro? Forced his name on a motherfucking contract.
Me on. I don't know.
And try to get $10 million.
Damn, that like recently?
Recently.
His brother?
His own brother.
His blood brother.
Damn. That nigga's a dirty motherfucker.
That's
man.
Crazy.
How would you feel about that? If your brother doesn't feel like that, or your mama, your sister, or anybody in your family close?
$10 million, you had to force my name for $10 million. Like we could have chopped it up however you wanted to do it, but you trying to do it behind my back?
Behind his back.
You know what I'm saying? What'd he say? Hey, that's crazy, man.
Boosie got a lawsuit on that nigga. That nigga's going to jail fucking with that nigga, boy.
Or is it criminal?
That's what I'm saying.
I'm going to keep it a bit. I really don't know. I don't want to cap on No Cap TV, but I just know that the nigga motherfuckers forged his name. I seen Boosie talking about his damn self, like, my brother, bro. And he was like, I don't give a fuck. I cut my mama or anybody off, especially do some shit. Like, he already don't fuck with his mama type shit.
Man.
But, nigga, he found out that nigga did that type of shit, bro. And he got a lawsuit against that nigga. Like, he's going to jail. He's sorry.
When you talk about them kind of people that's playing with money, I feel like that's the only way you could... Even that's your family, that's probably like the only right way he could have handled it was taking it to like legal standards.
Got to.
You feel me? But
what would you would have did? Like would you have motherfucking took it to legal, or would you have fought your brother? Would you have shot him? Would you have
it like I say, it all depends on what kind of level you is. And like Boosie at an age, he's older, he's more understanding, he got a lot more to lose. He might do something, he might have somebody do something to him, and Boosie right back in it. You know
no
what I'm saying?
Cap,
right?
We gotta run it at Thanksgiving dinner. Hey, we gotta run it Thanksgiving.
Hey, that too, but I mean in regarding that much money, nigga, God. You gotta
nigga,
go.
Nigga, what? You gotta catch this fame.
For real,
nigga,
right when I'm scooping the dress and I'm dropping the plate.
Oh yeah, my nigga right here, man. Y'all didn't know my nigga Slim was in the motherfuckers back.
I'm Detroit Road, Detroit West.
Let him know who you is, bro.
Detroit Road, bitch.
Put the hood on the 6 mile, break mile, knock your ops down, pick her up, knock her back down, pull her tracks up. Yes, I slap girl. Yes, I slap dog. Yes, I slap loud. Yes, I slap a pussy nigga if he act out. Yes, I slap
proud. Everybody
out
right now, bro. Shout out to the city,
man.
Man.
Shout out
to
the whole Midwest, man.
That's
y'all know how we coming, man. That shit, wow. But, hey.
Yeah, my nigga slid through, so we, like, fuck, we gonna put him on the motherfucking show,
you
too. Fuck it. You know
yeah.
what I mean?
So, yeah.
We gonna have more and more and more guests. This is, like, our opening up, like, having guests on the show right now. You know what I'm saying? This is how I motherfucking work out. But then after this, we gonna have guests every weekend, probably.
Man, no cap. No cap.
I'm fucking with that.
We out here.
Man, oh, yeah. Oh, Diddy.
Oh, Diddy.
Diddy and Cassie. Mr. Take that. Hey. Cassie came out the woodworks and said, Diddy raped her.
And I believe it. Well, I don't know about that, but I believe the shit that he was putting her through,
yeah.
Like, Diddy look like one of them kind of niggas. And his name been surfacing in the air, like, with sex trafficking.
They said, man, Fruity.
Yeah. I can believe it, though.
He like niggas' booties.
Man.
Hey. I don't know, man. How you feel about Diddy being Fruity, man? Do you think the nigga really gay?
I mean, shit. I think So Fab spoke of it.
Right, it's a lot of people.
It's like, it's too many real niggas who, you know what I mean, I listen to, who I fuck with. They don't
some real shit.
Them out, you know what I mean?
More than one person saying the same thing about you. Nine times out of ten.
The Diddy parties.
Hey.
Yeah, them Diddy parties, boy.
Them Diddy parties. You know
nobody want to go to them Diddy parties. Hey, also, I did see that. Diddy was talking to Fabulous about going to his party. And Fabulous felt hella uncomfortable.
For
like,
real. Like, hey, man, you need to relax. Nigga, what? For real.
Type shit, yeah.
You gotta relax.
I'm smoking Diddy, nigga.
Diddy look like a freaky ass nigga.
Dude, what I'm saying. Then I heard a story. It's crazy because Young Jock did an interview and he was like, Diddy had like this mind control over Cassie. He was like, they was at a club one day and he seen a white female up there and her side of her head was shaved. He looked over at Cassie, was like, in the morning I need you to cut the side of your shirt. And she did it though.
Yeah.
Hey, it was wild.
I was wondering why that bitch had a side of her
shit. She had a side of her shit with side
bitches. Yeah, bitches with that bullshit.
Good ass.
He made that bitch go walk. Yeah, she made her go walk for some cheesecake. That bitch had
me. Like, damn, bitch, who lined you up, bitch?
Give me the nigga a number four right there.
She went in that bitch like, let me get the number seven on that motherfucker.
Number seven. You feel
me? Light that bitch up. Hey, speaking on like the gay fruit, I mean, hey, LGBTQ, don't, you know what I mean?
You
but
know what I'm saying?
Will Smith, they ain't giving my nigga a break, bro.
What?
They said that his manager, Will Smith's manager, said that he caught Dwayne Martin. You know who Dwayne Martin is?
I know. You talking about Mr. Butter Ram, star athlete from Butter Ram.
Gina Husband. Yeah.
Said that he caught them, he walked in on them. Why they keep fucking with Will like that, bro? Like, what is the Illuminati after this nigga? Or,
I don't know if it's the Illuminati. I don't know what it is, but at the end of the day, it's a lot of shit been going on with Will Smith for the last couple of years.
And
that
it's
just
crazy to even,
you know what I mean?
Foul everything, every hit.
And he done had his shit under wax for so long. You know what I mean? Like, none of his business getting out there. Until this whole situation,
and it's
crazy,
it's fogging my motherfucking memory because Will Smith, that's Mr. Fresh Print, like I, that shit is still
Will
in
is
my
that
head.
Nigga,
like,
bro.
That, yeah, like growing up,
Will's a legend.
Will, like, and y'all got all this crazy ass shit to say, but like I say, it's a crazy world. We in 2023, on to 2024, and shit just get wickeder and wickeder.
You know, whatever you do in your bedroom is what you do. Facts. You know what I mean? Like, I ain't against none of that. You know, it's cool people everywhere. You know what I mean? I ain't against that, but for your business to be put out there in the street, that's one thing.
That's messy.
You know what I mean? And that's messy as hell. That's messy as hell.
I feel like in that industry, I feel like you damn near got to do something fruity. Like, it's so many people in that industry
that's
doing fruity shit.
Your soul,
like,
though. But not to get too much into
Selling your soul is like you're doing something that you know you ain't got no business doing.
Right. For the younger generation. Right. For the younger generation, when it comes to selling your soul, it's not all about money and shit like that. It's what you're doing outside of your character that's beneath you. You know what I'm saying? So
you do something that you know you don't have no business doing, you know what I mean? And they get you to do that shit on for everybody to see in the world to see. And
well, it's so crazy. It feel like, do you really want it that bad?
A lot of people want it that bad, though.
Motherfuckers kill their mama for $400,000 insurance money.
Insurance
money. What they say, you know, to sell your soul for a Jelly Roll.
And they definitely doing it out here, man.
Oh, God, man. Niggas selling their soul. I ain't doing it. Before they came at you with $100 million.
Shit, give me a couple of bitches with some fool stamps. We thugging, you feel me?
I always say, I don't need that much money. I'm not doing no funny shit like that to work. They gonna give me the money to do some funny shit. I'm not doing, I don't need that much money.
Man,
it's good.
That shit is
I
crazy.
I'll
do something else.
Stamps, nigga.
Yeah.
Section 8. We hood rich, you feel me?
I heard about Snoop Dogg. Y'all heard about Snoop Dogg talking about he can stop
smoking? Let me hit that, nigga. I ain't gonna play. You
feel
me?
Speaking of nigga, pass the blunt.
Usually my nigga Rick don't smoke with me on the show.
Right,
I'm so used to hoeing that motherfucker.
Hey,
that's some bullshit.
I think he
capped. I don't know, bro. He might be
smoking his whole motherfucking life. What is he to stop?
He probably trying to try something new.
I mean, yeah, I feel like it's a mental. It's a what they call.
He getting old.
Nah, not even old. I don't even look at it like that. Maybe he wanted to
evolve.
Evolve and he wanted to push himself to a new limit. But it's like, Nigga, he been doing it this whole motherfucking time, bro. He been doing this whole motherfucking time, so like, why now? Like, we need an explanation, for real.
That's some bullshit. Snoop, nigga, come on. I always, my dream is to smoke a blunt with Snoop Dogg. Like, I do music, my nigga. That Snoop is like somebody that I want to meet. Like, I look up to Snoop. I fuck with Snoop, man, nigga. Like,
been doing it for what? A long time.
My whole life, since I was a kid, crazy. Nigga. Like, Snoop, nigga, what?
Since the early 90s?
That's crazy. Yeah, like,
and he been blowing
ever
since
Ever since he came on.
He damn near made his shit cool.
Snoop is a weed icon. Like, he's when you think of weed, you think of Snoop. You think of Snoop, you think of weed. Just like, right. How could you not smoke? That's like taking the dog away from him.
Facts.
Like, you know what I mean? That's crazy.
Man.
Another thing. Did you watch the, what's the nigga name? The Steve Secure Stevens?
The fight?
The fight. I didn't watch it,
but I seen how bad, like, how people... Well, he said he had a bad performance. He was great in his performance, but they said he was running this shit, so I don't know.
That nigga was running so much. The Dominican nigga, that nigga was copying that nigga. He turned his back on him and acted like he was running mid-fight.
Damn, so they clowning?
Clowning that nigga, bro.
But he won, though. They said he still won.
But yeah. He just outboxed.
All I gotta say, though, because is him and Tank in the same way when they can fight each other?
Yeah.
I don't think you want to see Tank.
Tank can beat the brakes off that boy.
Yeah, beat that nigga down. So
I don't know. Tank
got your Crawford cam, right?
Who? Shakur?
Yeah.
Yeah, Crawford, like his mentor. Yeah. Like, he fucked with him.
Yeah, he walked out with Crawford, as a matter of fact.
Yeah.
That niggas went crazy, but I don't know. That... Motherfuckers go pay to see them fights, and a nigga got a big name. For you to be running the whole fight, like, come on, bro.
But who you think made that shit cool where, like when people say boxing ain't what it used to be, but Floyd. they blame Floyd.
Yeah, Floyd is a defense fighter. He's a strategy fighter. Floyd know how to win fights.
Like, only knock I have on Floyd is he made it so, like, niggas don't want to lose their O. Like, back in the day, Tyson and them niggas didn't care about losing. They came to put on a show.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Now, Mayweather is... He got these people so focused on, if you lose your O, you nobody now.
That's big, bro. You never lost a fight. That's big,
but people want to showcase the real fight. They not putting these real fights against each other because they scared that they could lose.
I think that it's more of entertainment now.
It's money, too.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm like, it's money. If they wanted to entertain, they'd get the people to fight.
More people that you have to come and pay pay-per-view to watch the fight, more money that you're making. You know what I'm saying? So if you can put a fight together and I can make you win this fight and then somebody win the second fight, and then we get a three fights out of that. Yeah. You know how big that bag is? You know what I mean?
It's all about money. I wanted to ask y'all too, bro. Like, just a whole other totally different topic. Like, how you feel about, like, switch the topic. What you rather have? Like, loyalty out of motherfucker or respect out of a motherfucker?
And that's crazy. Me and my boy Fly Behind the Camera, man, we had this conversation a lot. And what he was saying is, like, if you don't have, it's vice versa. If you don't have loyalty, how can you have respect? If you don't have respect, how can you have loyalty? I feel like it's interchangeable. It's like you can't really have one without the other, because if you're loyal to somebody, you clearly respect them because you're loyal to them. But if you respect somebody, maybe you could be disloyal. I don't really know, but I feel like they're interchangeable. They it's kind of hard to have one and not the other.
Yeah, straight up.
I was gonna say they flow on the same.
Okay, so I would take path. Would you take loyalty or love?
Man, come on now. I preach loyalty so much, bro. Like, I don't want no female to ever say they love me. I don't want none of my niggas to say they love me. Show me, bro. Show me you ain't never did nothing fluff. You ain't never did nothing crazy. Loyalty is a big thing, and that's 2023, like, this generation don't understand what loyalty is, bro.
Straight up.
Like, they've used love so easily and like it's in a head, bro, but loyalty is an action, bro. It's an action, bro. So you have to show that, for real.
Yeah. Word up. I mean, on a deeper shit, love is, too.
Yeah, I mean, love is, but in this generation? Yeah,
in this generation, no, we don't see that, but shit, love is a motherfucker, too. You know what I mean? It still happens.
Mm-hmm.
It's just rare.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It still happens, still going on. Love and loyalty is still running on the same, you know what I'm saying, in the same car. Facts. It's rare, bro. It's rare as fuck.
Yeah. That's fuck.
And we were just talking about this off camera, but masculine females nowadays, man, it's like, it's so crazy to have a relationship where these females they want to be more masculine than the men. It's crazy. They too aggressive. Like, I don't know where that shit comes from.
I don't want no gangster.
I don't want no gangster. You feel me? I don't need no gangster at all. You feel me? Hey, you feel me?
Suck my dick, nigga.
Hey, New York, Chicago, Cali. females, bro, y'all gotta get it together, bro. Ladies,
shit,
ladies.
Detroit girls too.
Like,
yeah.
Let's chill it. Like, let's calm it down a little like, bit, Baltimore, man. Philly. You ain't gotta be. You feel me?
ATL.
I don't want no bitch to act like no nigga, bro. But it's a lot of these niggas acting like females.
And that's probably why they act like it, nigga. You know what I mean? Probably why they
it's
act like that.
It's a lot of niggas acting like bitches. You know what I'm saying? So these bitches gotta act like niggas.
I don't blame the females though. I blame these niggas though. We gonna talk about it. I blame these niggas. I blame these females.
Y'all straight like
y'all make it easy for every female to just get exactly what it is that they want. Man. It seems like you gonna be quick to show the husband duties before they show some wifey duties. So now at the end of the day, only thing you gotta offer is what, nigga, your paycheck. Cause you ain't getting no buns. She coming to a nigga like me. You feel me? Like, so shit. Like, I'm gonna knock her motherfucker back out. You feel
like,
me?
Hey, it's funny, like that little TikTok. The nigga was like, hey, stay on my girl DM. See, the nigga sent it out. He sent it back. She's like, yeah, he sent it. Yeah, nigga, he sent the thousand, nigga. Right. We finna go to Red Lobster right now, nigga. Yeah, nigga, I'm hungry, motherfucker, nigga.
For real, because, hey, I mean, shit. You know, hey, fly what they say, nigga. You see a duck, pluck a duck.
Man.
You feel me? So, shit, it ain't. It be a lot of. They be saying that the females ducks, no, these hoe ass niggas, bro.
Yeah, it's wild.
It's these niggas that be ducks. Niggas,
and they watering the game down.
For real, they be all ready to buy a bag for a bitch, all ready to spend a bag on a bitch, all ready to do all types of shit on the bitch.
I'm talking about immediately.
And guess what? You gonna hit tomorrow, and I'm gonna hit the next day.
Well, I think that too. A lot of niggas don't have no game. Some niggas don't know how to talk to a female.
That's right, tricky.
So they use their money to get bitches.
Man. Yeah, but they think they're doing the right thing. Like,
don't get me wrong.
They want to impress
the
bitch.
If I rock with the chick, I'll spit a couple of dollars. Like, let's go have a good time. It's for my entertainment anyway.
Yeah. Right.
So if I want to go to the game, I'm going to go grab a little female. Hey, come and ride with me. If I want to go somewhere and get something nice to eat, I'm going to grab a lady. Hey, come with me. But it ain't going to be on her time like she calling me talking about what we, you know what I'm saying? What we on tonight? What's on the flow?
Bitches call niggas like, I need my nails done. Cash at me.
Like,
I need what the fuck?
Hey.
And then if you don't do it, she got attitude.
She got a big attitude. Like, you, like.
I didn't see niggas argue with bitches on the phone. Like, I didn't get paid this week. Like, damn, nigga. Let me talk to that bitch
nigga
for you.
Nigga fumbled the bag and shit. Nigga done fumbled the bag, baby.
I'm about to bounce back.
Do you
believe in 50-50, or this should be what? What should? How do you feel like your relationship should go?
Depends on where I'm at.
Right. Yeah. I was just gonna say it depends on where the male at. But like we talked about last show, man. You not finna be able to keep these females nowadays. Like these motherfuckers want that bag. So like I say, if you 50-50, I don't have no problem with that. I understand that, but it depends on
where you at.
Yeah,
what type of woman you got?
Straight up,
that's what it
you
is.
You feel me? Like at the end of the day, if she's a materialistic type of female, my
you
nigga.
Lose that one, that ain't.
She was when somebody can do better than you can.
Yeah,
she's gone anyway.
Even if
you spending 20 stacks on her, it's gonna be a nigga that's gonna spend 50.
Right, and that's why y'all gotta be
a next best thing. You know what I mean?
Right, so that's our generation. Next best thing. And what an MBT, nigga, next best thing.
We gonna name this next best thing.
Yeah.
Yo, I like that.
Next, yeah, you feel
MBT
right here.
MBT bitches.
Next best thing. That's why you stop chasing these MBT bitches because that's all they own is the bad.
I call them PF double Bs.
Yeah, go ahead.
Pretty face broke bitches.
Broke bitches, because that's really all they is.
Bitches be pretty as a motherfucker. Yeah. Bitches got on a $40 outfit. Go out there and trick y'all niggas. Throw some makeup on. Niggas gonna spend $5.
We ain't gonna be here.
Niggas go put on nigga $3,000 worth of shoes, $1,000 pants. Nigga,
and that's the shit that be blowing me.
They buying tables, all
it's
this.
It's not that deep to grab a female, my nigga. Like if you really about yours and you 100, you stand on your shit, my nigga. The way you ain't even gotta do all that.
You ain't gotta do all that. But like we talked about this last show, a lot of niggas is doing this not even for the female. They doing this to impress other niggas.
Yeah.
Compete, nigga. What for? What, nigga?
I got more money than you.
Tight shit, and that's wrong intent you bringing. So
niggas in competition. Yeah. Like bitches.
Like bitches.
Females be a competition, bro.
I ain't gonna lie, nigga. When I was, all right, I'm gonna tell y'all a quick story.
Yeah, go ahead. Story time,
nigga. Nigga, I was like 22, 23, nigga, going into the club, popping bottles and shit.
Facts.
And I could see myself, like, nigga, I could see myself really on some, like, nigga, buy another bottle. Buy another bottle. Nigga, I'm a boss in this bitch. You know what I mean?
Stunting, tricking, do you think it's the same thing?
Nah.
Yes.
Stunning, tricking.
Nah. It ain't tricking because I could be in that bitch stunting on my own just for my own, like, for my own shit. Like, nigga, I don't give a fuck about no nigga in this bitch. I don't give a fuck about no bitch in this bitch. Yeah. Nigga, I'm in this bitch.
Off camera questions, but if you stunting, when you stunting, don't you feel like you give to everybody when you stunting to them?
Nah.
You know? So you don't walk in the club
with,
like,
my people, though. What? I'm doing it with my people.
If you taking care of your people, I feel like tricking is paying for a bitch or giving or using your money to obtain coochie, like some type of shit like that. Facts. You're trying to, at the end of this, you want to spend your money because you think that's going to impress her, and you think at the end of this, you're going to get you some pussy. For me, I think that's what
tricking is. Facts.
The definition of
or
tricking.
Or you know what it is, and she like shit, nigga. Because there's females out here that be like, nigga, you want to hit, nigga? I need this.
What's the definition of stunning?
Definition of stunning is having a good time now. Now you showing your ass. You can be just, you know what I mean?
So if we in here, right?
You in.
For example, if we go out, we go step out this weekend or something like this, and I'm like, nigga, I'm buying bottles all night, nigga, till we can't. Nigga,
and not, okay, yeah, to me, yeah, stunning is, I didn't buy these bottles or I didn't do nothing to try to impress no bitch. I just did it because this is what I wanted to do. Like, right. You know what I mean? To have me a good time.
Yeah.
So if I felt like, nigga, I got my bread right,
yeah.
I want to buy 10 bottles tonight, nigga, and whatever the fuck, nigga, I'm buying 10 bottles for me.
Straight up.
Nah, I'm not finna go, okay, my plan is, I'm finna buy 10 bottles and it's gonna be hella bitches, nigga. They sold 10 bottles, nigga. The bitches gonna run over there, nigga. I can't wait.
My
plan is to buy the bottles to get the bitches.
Bitch, nigga, I knew from the time I got my hair cut.
Yeah. I'm finna
have my outfit on.
And I said, I'm finna
shit on. I'm shitting on everything. Yeah.
I'm finna set the club down, nigga, tonight. Nigga, I'm coming to shut this motherfucker down. What? Nigga, I bought 15 bottles.
Yeah.
One bottle, two bottles.
Right.
You get a bottle. Right. You get a bottle.
We in this bitch like Oprah.
See, that's
that bitch in this motherfucker. Pause. Nigga, we in this bitch.
Oh, mama. I did some shit like that.
For real.
Man. That shit is wild, nigga. And then just a minor, we're going to take a little display. What the fuck you call it? Not display.
Intervention,
motherfucker. Yeah, that my nigga back there. Intervention. We just want to say R.I.P. Shy Bucks, man. Today is 11/19. You know what I'm saying? So his home going. He passed away 2 years. It's been 2 years. It's crazy to say it's been 2 years, man. But long live CB.
Long live Buck, bro. That's my motherfucking brother. You feel me? If y'all know me, y'all know him, nigga. That's a touchy-ass situation. Like, nigga, what? I don't want to cry on the show tonight. You know what I'm saying?
But we definitely just had to dedicate
we had a big old barbecue. I appreciate everybody that came out to fuck with us. You know what I mean? We had big barbecue. Bikes pulled up. You understand me? Big family vibe. That shit was cool in the motherfucker. Yeah. In the park, nothing. No bullshit. Everybody was just vibing, listening to music, eating kids, playing. Like, that's what this shit is about. And, nigga, I want to keep my nigga name alive as forever. Like, you know what I'm saying? As long as I'm alive, I'm gonna keep my nigga name alive. So I'm gonna always do something for my brother and make sure that nigga's straight. You feel me?
Facts.
So rest in peace to my bro. You feel me? We're gonna do a little quick moment of silence for my nigga Buck. You feel me? Before we jump into the next topic.
This nigga.
You know what I mean?
You feel me? Long live.
Long live Buck, though.
You feel me?
Bow y'all heads and do a moment of silence, bro. Was not a moment.
Moment of silence.
You still talking, bro, nigga.
I'm stupid.
He said, let's do it.
Yeah, do it.
Exactly.
He said, do a moment.
But look, in regard to that, sometimes you got to laugh to keep from crying, man. Y'all know how that shit goes.
Buck, nigga, what? Nigga, we'll be right here laughing like he know me. Like,
you know what it is. It's,
you know I'm retarded like that, bro. Like,
you
know what I'm saying? I can't help it.
Would you fuck with the OnlyFans bitch?
Like, in which way?
Like she do OnlyFans, but you ain't her only, like, she do, she
you ain't her only fans.
Yeah. She tricking, basically.
She, like, yeah, she, like, can my bitch have OnlyFans?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, you goddamn right. You know what I'm saying? You goddamn right. You feel me? What?
What's that mean?
If you know me, yeah, you know me, huh? What?
Sorry, hold on.
Can your girl have an OnlyFans? Will you be mad if your bitch had an OnlyFans? I'm sorry, no disrespect, but your girl had an OnlyFans.
My girl.
Had an OnlyFans?
No.
You would be mad?
I wouldn't be mad.
He just said no.
I wouldn't be mad, but that shit just not right. I'm just not going for that shit. Can some of my hoes, like the little,
situations.
I don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? But not your main. But my main, what I'm going home to, that I'm over here hanging up the armor
30
to.
30 grand, like, my friend. You know what I'm saying? 30 grand, my friend.
Who cheat more, man or woman?
Big females. What?
Oh shit.
Females cheat hard. They dirty. I don't know. Man. Niggas is dogs. And it seems like it's just niggas is dumb. They just do it. It's just right there on front
street. I'm gonna tell you why.
I'm gonna tell you why, bro.
They obviously most liquor.
A female, you feel me? They got the low control, especially these pussy hungry ass niggas. If a female see a nigga tonight, boom, she see you. You a pussy hungry ass nigga. She say, I'm gonna fuck Rico tonight.
Yeah.
9 times out of 10, these pussy hungry hound ass niggas, they gonna fuck. They don't give a fuck. Yeah. She got an ass or whatever the fuck. Yeah. They're gonna fuck. Now a nigga can't just straight point a bitch out like, I'm fucking her tonight.
Yeah.
When you walk up to her, she may not even say nothing to you.
Right. You're right.
He said,
I mean, you can't. I mean, you got that game. You know what I mean? But you,
I mean,
I'm just saying 9 times out of 10 statistically.
Yeah, because you got women are the gate.
You know what I mean?
Come on. You know what I'm saying?
They're the gate holders. Like, and that's what niggas want.
Yeah, they.
But
you're saying they cheat more, though. How?
I won't say that.
Females?
That contradicts it.
I'm going to tell you why. Because it's females cheat more because they can. Nigga, at any time they want.
All right, let's unfold this.
It's easier for them.
But how you saying that? But I feel like a nigga will fuck anything. So
right, that's what I'm saying. Let's unfold this.
And I don't
want to
speak for a female either.
A nigga will fuck. I know niggas know how to fuck a snake if you hold the head. You know what I'm saying? A nigga will fuck. There's some horn dogs out there. I know some horny ass niggas.
Exactly, so say that. I don't know.
I know some niggas that are fucking. Hey,
niggas horny than a motherfucker.
But. Bro, nigga can't get pussy on demand like that. Like, and that's why they so horny. You know what I'm saying? Because he can't fuck any and every bitch he want to. He got bitch that he's... Niggas be on camera lusting that hoes. Like,
I don't know, bro. Like,
and niggas like you got...
But what's the conversation we have?
Like,
who cheats more?
Okay, can we unfold this? Let's unfold this, right?
From the top to the bottom.
From the top to the bottom, right? I want to try to unfold this shit.
Right, because
this is... I cannot necessarily say who cheats more.
Either race?
I will ask, not I will break it down, either. Who is more deceitful in the way that they cheat?
Who's smoother?
Female.
So, to me, I've been like, damn, shit, we'll never know. Sometimes niggas never know.
And it's what's crazy, look, you don't know.
They're so smooth. You don't even know. We think we're going to take it to their grave.
You won't even know your bitch cheated. Look, you will cheat. She catch you cheating. She'll tell you she cheated. Bitches will be honest with you.
No, bitches. Bitches will. A bitch will be out with her nigga. A bitch will be out cheating all day with her nigga. And catch you. A bitch will be out cheating. Bitches is crazy, bro. It's deep. A bitch will be out all day cheating with a nigga. Come home, catch you in some bullshit cheating, mad at you. Cussing you a bitch ass nigga.
What about this one?
Get out.
They be mad at you. Because of the other nigga.
Like, what the fuck? Because
the other nigga that pissed them off.
So now this bitch come home checking your phone. Because this nigga that pissed her off.
And that's,
we was just cool.
So hear this, right? This is no cap TV.
I'm just saying,
this is no cap TV because this is wild.
So how could you literally do that in your mind? Like, that's some psychotic shit. Right. And be out cheating all day with a nigga. Right. And then come home and see a message or something from your nigga did something. Like the bitch picture.
Who's stronger?
In a situation?
Niggas.
When it comes to cheating, who's stronger?
Like, what you mean?
I think females are stronger. Females are stronger,
they
stronger.
They can take it. Hey. Nigga, you cheat one time, bitch, you're done.
Listen to me,
bro.
Who's stronger? Because
females
are stronger. Listen, because I feel like they're stronger because I'm more honest, nigga. A nigga will ask a bitch anything like,
hey, niggas, you want to see a nigga get
everybody.
Cheat on them. Tito your nigga tonight.
Die. Hey, I swear to
what? They be ready to kill.
Everybody see your nigga go crazy. Let him find out.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
Let that nigga find out.
It depends if the nigga was cheating too, though. Already.
True. It depends on how you feel out. But two, it depends on. At the same time, it depends on.
Not hell, dog ass nigga. But if you a dog ass nigga,
no, it depends on. It depends on how long you've been. It depends on how long you've been with the bitch and what type of relationship you. It depends on what type of relationship you have with a female. Because if you just being with a bitch or whatever, you just got with her or whatever, I don't really give a fuck about you anyway because I don't really know you like that. But long you've been with a female for so long and it's deep and y'all.
Okay, so how long here?
This, y'all can break up and you find out she fucking other niggas.
Off-camera question for the production. Okay. So how long do you think for you to be hurt?
I just had to put it back
long,
on.
How
it
long?
Just
how,
stopped.
Okay, it might be, the story might be going up, but I don't know.
How many years do it take for you to feel hurt over a bitch? How long?
To get over it?
No, not get over it. For you to be like, damn, I'm hurt when you leave, how many years do it take you?
What? Years, nigga? What?
Like,
what
the
fuck
you mean?
You talking about, nigga?
Okay, so.
you hurt right then and there. I feel like.
Oh, bitch, I'm getting off my feet.
Yeah. That's why a nigga be crushed. That's why he leave.
I'm saying, what I'm trying to say is, like you just said, if it's somebody you just met, and it's like
oh,
a month
okay.
or two.
Oh, how long? All right,
bitch, I don't give a fuck. But how long does it take for you?
It depends because
now y'all break
it
up.
Depends
you, like,
on, it depends
to be
on the vibe.
For 3 years
it depends
or
on the vibe
years.
That you had with the female. Because you can be with somebody else. Yeah,
my
longest.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, I found my nigga and shit, and now she done cut you off. Y'all been rocking and rolling like Bon Jovi, niggas, all the last 20 years and shit.
You been fixed. You fell in love with side
bitch. If you've been with her for a year, you okay to leave? And like, you'd be like, all right, fuck this.
It depends on what she did to me, too.
Like, what she did for you?
Like, no. I don't get, like, now, if what you did to me, it depends on, like, why I left you. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, how long I would take to get. Because if you did some shit like, I don't know, fuck my brother or some dirty shit like that, bitch, tomorrow, you're done. Yeah. Right now. Yeah. I don't give a flying fuck about you.
At the moment that I found out.
Yeah, you're, you know what I mean?
It kills you, yeah.
You're gone immediately. But if whatever the fuck, I say a nigga fucked up, I fucked up and it's gone. I'm gonna be fucked up hurt. Like, yeah.
It'd be more fucked up when they cut us off of some shit that we did.
That a nigga did.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Now, the question is, fellas, do we be more mad that we lost her or we be more mad that
we fucked up? Yeah.
Look, I'd be more mad that my bitch left. I ain't gonna lie.
For real?
Yeah, yeah. Because I'd be feeling it the next 2 days.
Nigga be in this bed.
There's a me TV in my bedroom.
I'm being a bitch. Now she done blocked your phone.
Then she her shit blow up on Facebook with all her threads and
shit. Going
and niggas should have
appreciated
me. I'm
pulling up.
Right. You know what I'm saying? With those posts, like, damn.
Dude, I'm just gonna pull up. Hey,
So you a pull up ass nigga?
Pull up ass nigga.
I ain't pulling up on shit
because
I.
But like, I honestly, that's cap because on some real shit. That is cap because when I'm mad at you, like if I'm mad about some shit, bitch, you're getting a cold shoulder that I won't say a word to you. You understand?
But is it because
you won't hear from me?
But like, that's how my mentality was. I used to do that where like I know this bitch gonna read back out.
Yeah, at some point.
At some point, but if she don't, you giving her the cold shoulder. She don't, you like, damn.
Damn, this bitch ain't calling. What the fuck? Quit playing, but that's what I'm saying. If I
What's
really
up,
fuck with
head?
You, yeah, it depends on how much I really fuck with her. Because if I really fuck with you, and I'm like, damn, this is my bitch, quit playing with me. Like, bitch, I'm gonna text you or I'm gonna call you or pull up. Like,
you ever waited too long and she just got with a new nigga?
Hell yeah, nigga, what? Nigga, what?
That shit hit the heart,
like,
don't
damn,
it?
This nigga got my bitch.
Damn,
fuck.
That shit hit the heart. Still,
that's when you really call her.
Not right now, you really in it.
What's up with it? So I see you with Tyrone. I see you with your little Tyrone, nigga.
Who cheat better?
Man, this is... Don't nobody know.
Who
cheat
better?
Nah, nigga, you gotta say women cheat.
I say
women
cheat
better. They don't get caught. Women don't get caught unless they won't get caught.
Niggas
get caught last
night. Niggas, yeah. Niggas don't be trying to get caught, but we're just dumb.
When y'all break up...
That's when you know.
That's when you be like...
Woo!
You did.
Talk about it, nigga.
That's a cold piece of work. Cold piece of work. For real, like this, so this whole time. You on my biscuit about some shit, but the whole time you was out here doing
that's
you.
That's what I was saying. Bitch be mad at you knowing she was just, she just left Tyrone.
Man,
how could you do that? Like, a nigga be out cheating all day. He not finna come home mad at you.
Right. You hungry?
Yeah. Like, ain't finna start nothing.
You
like,
trying to watch 600 pound fix my life. You know what I'm saying? Niggas come with a crib still the same. Man. Until you go through her phone. Like, why are you even fucking
the nigga phone?
You know what I'm saying? You fucked up the whole day now.
Female go through nigga phone. Y'all just left the movies. Y'all was having a good old time. You fuck around. Go in the store. Time. Leave your phone in the car while you go in the store. This bitch. Oh, in the car part.
Like, it's like some shit just activated.
Nigga hit his pocket. It's like, everybody know. You know, see, y'all fight at the same time. You hit your pocket. It's like, damn. My phone in the car.
Shit.
See, look like, ooh, this nigga left his phone.
And
in
it's
car.
Crazy because I bitch, come right after having a good ass day.
Okay,
a good
day. Okay, y'all just left the movie. Do y'all check women's phone?
Nah, I ain't gonna lie to you because my mentality is if you want to see some shit, and if you going through some shit, if you looking for some shit, you gonna find some shit. So just back up, you can do that shit.
I don't wanna know. If you play me, keep it on the low. Cause my heart can't take it anymore.
Bitch, I'm gonna kill you. Right. Don't do it. Hey.
Not beat your bitch ass if she out here doing crazy shit.
For real, man. Let that
bitch, I'm gone. Like Tyrone. I'm gone like a motherfucking deadbeat dad.
You gotta let her be.
And never came
them,
back home.
Listen, all them little... You feel me? Just go in and pull up over there night by night. Exactly. You know what I mean? Until you get your shit, your heart right. You feel me?
Night by night till you get your heart right. You heard what the fuck you said, nigga. Damn.
Night by night to get your heart right around this motherfucker, man.
Tired shit.
Nigga be sick, bitch, leave, man. Yeah, get to playing this for your ass.
Nigga,
I don't want to know.
Nigga be on the E-way like this.
Hey, nigga go through the phone like,
damn.
See that shit like.
So you, she done put the story in her, out to dinner, show the nigga chest and the rings and shit. Don't show shit on you.
Like, put your fucking clock at you.
Baby, come on,
I just want to
go home.
I'm
gonna kill you. That shit crazy.
I don't want to know, man. I ain't gonna lie, boy. That shit hit me one time. I broke up with a chick. That shit hit me one time, nigga. I'm like, what the fuck? Nigga,
it's the ones that you can't get back though. I feel like that's when hurt you.
I ain't feel like I got one of those, bro.
You ain't never lost one that you can't get back?
That I don't feel. I feel like I don't supposed to have her back, or nigga, shit.
My bitch fag off and go with another. My bitch fag off and leave with another nigga. You can't come back.
But that's crazy.
I'm saying,
bitch,
y'all don't want
you
back.
They always spin a block.
Bitch, come back with a bag or something. You feel me? That's the only way.
That gas.
I don't know how you gonna get me back. You know what I mean? You got to contact my nigga.
Yeah, that shit punching. You feel me?
I don't know, but you leave and go fuck with Tyrone. Yeah, go and stay over there. Jump back in the window.
I mean, yeah, you can spin a block.
But it just spits.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, I have to super rock with you.
Yeah,
man. What?
You know what I'm saying? What the?
Man.
But sometimes I just feel like shit. How I am now, like some females you might have had smashed back in the day and shit. They still cool people, bro.
Yeah.
They still cool people that. Y'all just have an understanding that we ain't smashing, ain't nothing like
ooh,
that.
Okay,
but
I can
still trust you. I can still, like, I still know that shit. You looking out for me and my good. Not all, but I'm just saying some.
How you feel about females having male friends and male friends having female friends?
That's a good point. Right. I'll let you answer first.
Yeah,
bro.
Go ahead, Matt.
I don't know. I'm not no jealous ass nigga.
Okay.
You feel me? Like, at the end of the day, like, if this is your friend or whatever, I don't know. That shit be weird because bitches that be having best friends, they be fucking their best friend, bro. I don't believe that bullshit.
That
yo.
Shit. you know how men think, ain't no way, because we really fucking, you never sexually advanced,
and then now I'm your best friend, so he get to do little crazy shit, slap your bitch booty when you're not around, and
that shit,
I don't know, you never know, like, cause they too, y'all too close, I don't know,
bro,
how you feel about that, your girl having a best friend, a male best friend,
and he not gay,
and he not gay, straight, male best friend.
Mm-hmm.
That's like
because you gotta think about it. When y'all ain't going right, she confiding in this nigga.
And he telling, yeah, I don't know.
You, I mean, that's like what that. Okay, that can be the case, right? But until I know, mm-hmm. I can't. Right. Speculate, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not going to speculate. Yeah. You know what I'm
saying? Would you allow?
I have to. Because the man that I am, I have female friends.
Now, yeah, if you probably had this male best friend prior to me meeting you or whatever.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I can't change that.
Because I can't come into the situation telling you to cut this friend off, cut that friend off. Because at the end of the day, if I do that, but that means shit. I'm giving you permission to do the same thing in my life.
Facts. So,
is any more of those D's left?
That was smooth as hell on y'all. Yeah. Shout out to my boy Ryan, man.
Yeah, shout out to my nigga Ryan. Get some water and see. Shout out to my nigga Ryan today for production, man. Getting this right with the Wild Wild.
But you know what I'm saying? This episode is probably going to be a long ass episode, but we finna keep it rolling, man.
We finna keep it lit around this motherfucker, man. This Hennessy busting off right now. I'm going to let y'all know that. You feel me? Kids out of school. Nigga ain't got to get up early and take no kids to school in the morning.
You know what I'm saying? We're going to be in the bed. Rub my feet together.
Hey, man, you know what I'm saying? Nigga need to be at the club or something right now. You know what I'm saying?
Tight shit.
I'm going to get sponsored by Hennessy around this motherfucker, man.
Let's talk about children, man. How y'all feel about
kids.
Yeah, how you feel about dating a female with a kid?
I don't know. I ain't never do it again. Because I ain't got no kids. So, I didn't hear from y'all. Smart man learned from his mistakes. A genius learned from another man's mistakes. So, we gonna. Mm-hmm. I don't have no kids. All my people got kids. So, I want to understand why he said that. He said he wouldn't do it. You wouldn't do it either?
I would.
Okay, you go.
I have a kid, you know what I mean? So, if you got kids, you know what I mean?
It's different.
Cool. Yeah. I don't give no fuck. It depends, though. I don't want no bitch with hella kids, 5-6 kids and all that. I can't be all these kids' daddy. Like, I can't do that. I have one child. So, I think that's my cap. If I fuck with a female with one child, and that's it. I can't do it. I can't say no because I got a kid. So a female got a kid, I'll fuck with her with a kid. But
okay,
if I did have my son, I would fuck with a bitch with no kids. I'd rather have a bitch with no kids all day. Like,
that's what? A question.
I'm a man with kids.
Okay, good.
Yeah, I'm a man
and
with
I
kids.
Still
wouldn't do it.
Won't do it.
Damn.
You don't want no kids.
It's a lot.
I'm gonna break this shit down. I'm gonna unpack it. Number one, my attachment.
Yeah,
that I have when I go in and I'm really doing that, and I'm daddy.
See,
for real.
We gonna speak on what niggas
you know
is
what
doing
I'm saying?
And
like
that
when niggas is really
because
like I got an attachment to you know what I mean?
To this,
I'm gonna do
that. Life,
shit,
but they're not gonna be taking that road
kind of
thing.
Right.
They just
end
it for the
female.
So
it's almost like
I
break up with the mom. When I break up with the mom, I break up with the kids. So not only is I'm breaking up with one heart, I got. One, two, maybe three, maybe four. Because
I'm gonna really look out for the kid.
Because,
I really love the kid. Like if I fuck with the female like that,
damn.
Yeah,
I'm gonna fuck with.
How this nigga 20? What the fuck?
No, but if I had no kids, I wouldn't fuck with no bitch with no kids. I'm sorry.
He's a goddamn.
If I had zero kids, if you had kids, it'd be a deal breaker. Sorry,
it's a deal breaker right now.
Damn.
Straight up. The second reason why is because at the end of the day,
I can't take another care of
them. I can't no longer do it again because you could be doing more for those kids than the biological father.
Hell yeah.
Even, and sometimes in some man cases, you're doing more for her kids than you do.
The father is not around.
You got to extra prove to these kids and everything else
that they're here with you because you know what I'm saying.
So I feel like
exactly.
That's what it is too.
So it's like
your kids start looking at it different because I know that's
So it's like when I go into a new situation, she ain't got no kids, right? It's like if we do decide. That's another thing. Like, I still walk away with my kids, bro. Yeah. If me and you separate, I still got something, you know what I mean, to cherish out this situation, which is our kids.
Man, you feel me? To jump off that, it's crazy now this day how bitches is getting pregnant and not with their baby daddy, like, the next couple months.
And got so many demands on the next nigga. Oh, I don't need a nigga to do this and do... What happened to the last three niggas? The last three, four baby daddies you had that couldn't, like... That it can't be the baby daddies.
It's like these people is getting pregnant and then nigga be out of there. I'd be like, damn.
Immediately. Like, well, where is the dad?
Let's talk about the man that's not protecting their sperm, though.
Yeah.
Listening to my OGs over here, man, I don't know if I can do it, man. I'm understanding what they're saying. But.
They got a full beard.
You feel me? But yeah, man, I would talk to a female with kids, but just how I carry myself. You know what I'm saying?
You would or wouldn't?
I would.
Yeah.
I have and I would, but it's like, I don't, you feel me?
90% of these females got kids. That's because ain't almost majority of the women that they got kids. You got to.
So,
all you bitches got kids, and the baby daddy is nowhere in the
picture. But it's crazy how it's a double standard, because a female be acting funny with a nigga that got kids.
Won't date a nigga with kids.
Because she wants all yours for her and hers, nigga.
Yeah,
that's exactly what it is. No, for real.
You gotta fuck with my kid heavily.
Yeah, like if
you don't fuck with my kid, I can't fuck with
you. My kids come first in any situation. Like, I don't give a damn, like, yeah, this shit can end. But right now, my kids, though, they gonna be here.
I'm gonna say
that. And that's kind of filtering out, because you can see these male figures, they not even caring about their
kids. Niggas don't get no fuck. Man. That's some crazy.
That's kind of why I don't even.
They really, but a lot of people having babies on the wrong terms. Like, niggas get a bitch pregnant, just be like, okay, I just want to get her pregnant so I can, whatever happens, I can still be around.
Brown, Tyson, that's weird.
They didn't really go through nothing. Because niggas would be like, damn, bro, she bad. You ain't got her pregnant yet? Yeah. Like, what the? I would have been nutted in that, nigga. What?
Crazy as hell, nigga.
I know you heard some niggas. I know you heard niggas.
I said it before. Nigga, what's up? Nigga, I had a cold ass bitch. Nigga, cold ass
bitch. I'm about to say, I didn't say that before. Like, I should have nutted in
him. I should have nutted in that.
Hey, you know what's crazy about everyone?
But we know somebody in real life.
Nigga don't really want the baby, he just wanted like a reason to be in the bitch life. Like, you know what I'm saying? No matter what happens,
hit that motherfucker.
Yeah, no matter what happens,
there's no cap, nigga. Yeah. I ain't gonna lie,
nigga. He figure in his mind, no matter what happens, whoever, nigga, she with, I'ma still be able to come around, bitch, got my baby.
Hey, I tried. Hey, she had two abortions, nigga. She had two abortions.
Damn, he was like, no.
He did it like, yeah, I did it. Then thought like, no, I did it. No, I did it.
Oh God, I feel that.
Hey, I did that shit, man. But shit, that was when the nigga was young and nigga was dumb and shit.
Yeah,
man.
Hell yeah, nigga did a lot of dumb shit when they was a kid. You
see, that's
me?
Why I got. I'm trying to peep game. So,
man.
Who's the OGs of music?
The OGs of music.
Right now?
Nigga, like Jim Mac, y'all better go look me the fuck up. You understand me? You better Google me, bro, this motherfucker. Book me, bitch. Yeah.
For real, man. Book this.
How y'all niggas feel about Kanye?
Jay-Z.
Man, Kanye is the realest nigga out, nigga.
I swear to God. He ain't crazy,
nigga,
bro.
If y'all ain't woke if you don't understand. That's what I'm saying. You ain't really woke.
He's just too much of a real nigga.
That's why they keep trying to portray him as crazy, bro.
He too much of a real nigga. So.
But this is everything that he said in Drink Champs, though. He said he spoke about Diddy and what he was doing at Drink Champs, and everybody thought he was crazy and going wild.
He do dress
the same thing
still,
about them people. You know what I'm saying? And everybody thought he was crazy and wild, but he ain't speaking nothing but the facts, bro.
Facts.
It's just something that we see it, but consciously we just like shit. Like, I'm just trying to survive today. You know what I mean? I'm trying to survive today instead of trying to fix the situation.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Break this cycle that we going through.
They control the masses.
Yeah,
they control the masses, so the masses is saying that he's dumb, so people is followers, and they, oh, yep, Kanye's dumb. He's stupid.
He
don't know what he's talking about.
He's
crazy.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
But motherfuckers ain't woke enough to understand and dig deep, because it's a big mission that these motherfuckers is trying to put over our head that people don't know. Like, you got to really dig deep into a lot of stuff that's going on. Don't believe everything on social media.
Hell no, nah, don't believe
people
everything.
Whole life be social media. Like, you know what I'm
common
saying?
Common sense shit.
Yeah,
most shit that is common sense. You know what I mean? It's right there.
Did he put
I don't like. I can't stand Charleston White, bro. I'm keeping a band with you, bro. This the same nigga that was talking about he a snitch and talking about he voted for Trump and all that crazy ass weird shit. And y'all, why is y'all like on for real?
That nigga tell you, Soulja Boy.
Yeah, like, this nigga got some pepper spray and mace like a bitch. Like, hoes got pepper spray. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, bro. Like, Charleston White, like, that's weird to me, bro. You the same motherfucker, I don't know, trying to be funny, or that's not even, like, I don't know, trying to for views. But if y'all look back, before the man got kind of, like, popping or whatever, the man was saying he was voting for Trump. He had on Trump outfits.
He
great
wish
America.
All niggas wasn't, yeah.
He wish all niggas and
like,
all
I heard
this.
That
and
shit. Yeah, and
this man is weird to me, bro. And
I feel like because
like,
the way he delivered it and the way that he came off and his character.
White power. Come on, bro.
His character, what he was saying, I feel like
he's gonna call the police. You know how you say
the nigga don't listen to the messenger, messenger listen to the message right? Yeah. Type of shit. But it was almost like the message couldn't. I can't even listen to the message because of the message. The
messenger was just so.
Yeah, 6ix9ine, you know what I mean? 6ix9ine uncle. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, come on, man. This man is. I got a quick question.
I just want. How y'all feel? Biden did.
Trash. Give us more money, weird ass nigga. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't heard shit about
I voted for
PPP.
Trump.
Exactly. You know what I mean?
I voted for
Trump. Trump's out here doing this shit. Y'all was talking all that shit about Trump.
I voted
nigga.
For Trump.
Trump was look, look. Look, look. Hey, nigga, you gotta think about it, though. Trump
that nigga, though. I'm voting for him next year. Trump. We need Trump right here. Goddamn it.
He's right here, guys.
You know what I'm saying?
It's not even about
him. Trump going through shit like a real nigga. Nah,
look, Trump is a motherfucking businessman, executive businessman. Yeah. That's why he was giving out money. Trump is that nigga is about the money. I ain't gonna, you cannot take that from that nigga. That nigga since I ever been born, that man been old and rich. Like
old and rich. That's
all you ever knew about him.
He's so rich, he became the president.
Yeah. And he was the one of the only presidents that didn't take presidential pay.
No money. This nigga's flying his own plane.
Right.
Yeah. This, like,
I'm not going to get too deep into it.
Yeah.
Not too deep.
Right.
That shit crazy.
Trump is for the people. Trump, because at the end of the day, when you stimulate the economy, that means that money is flowing.
So you think Trump is racist?
Yeah. He might be, but I mean, that don't got nothing to do with
it. I don't think so. At the end of the day, what I can say is that shit... All of us have some shit that we say about every motherfucking race that we don't like.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? And at the end of the day, you can't hold that man account. You can't hold that man to the standards of the same thing that we'll think.
Shit, black people talk about black people.
You know what I'm saying? Black people talk about black people. Shit, we understanding motherfuckers where we talked about white people, Chinese people, everybody. Goddamn, we talk about motherfuckers. Whatever it is, nigga, it is what it is.
He just be doing stuff to women. Like, he grabbed that girl by the vagina on stage.
They all the presidents.
You got to in 2023, nigga. Motherfuckers is freaky now.
They all
you
got to
grab them by the coochie. Oh, nigga, because, nigga, you fuck around.
You going to jail, buddy. You better not do no shit like that.
I'm just saying. For you to be 73 grabbing coochies. Anybody feel something that you got, nigga, fuck around.
For you to be 73 grabbing coochies, though, that's out of line.
That's crazy. Yeah, that's
you know, it's Thanksgiving is coming up around this motherfucker. Especially for me. She making me seafood macaroni, mac and cheese, baked mac and cheese, seafood
okay.
with the lob and the crab and that motherfucker.
Really crazy. Hey. I ain't going to talk. I just like that. No, sweet potato. You know, my candy ass and the macaroni, when they touch, though.
With the marshmallow?
Yeah, cool.
With the marshmallow?
It's that when they touch, though. When they
overlapping? With the sound. He's the manufacturing smell. With the
I ain't gonna lie, I'm not a
turkey.
Nah.
Look, turkeys be dry. I'm gonna keep it a band with you. My mama turkey is one of the best turkeys. Her turkey be fall off the bone. The motherfucker be juicy. I don't know what she do to that motherfucker, but she do something to it.
Slim over there, he eat green bean casserole and shit.
Who's gonna be eating green bean casserole?
That's why. Fly by the camera. Definitely eat some green bean casserole. Casserole these ass niggas.
So I'm doing,
me and Dom doing
Thanksgiving.
Okay.
What?
Okay.
Ice cranberry.
Frank's
Red Hot.
No.
Going
I don't like cranberry sauce.
So you're a Frank? You Louis Evans?
No, I'm a Red Hot.
Yeah, you a Louis Evans?
I like, a lot of people don't know about Crystal.
Yeah,
Crystal hot sauce.
Yeah, I fuck with
you
that.
You fuck with the Crystal. Yeah. These niggas don't know. No, Crystal is.
Yeah.
This nigga don't know Crystal
hot. I'm going to stick with my Red Hot, nigga. That's it.
Hey, what kind of, okay.
Red Hot number one.
What do you call Larry's? What's your nickname?
Season salt.
Season salt. I call
it's season salt, nigga. It's not
season salt. Season all. Season all salt. You know what I'm saying? I call it season all.
I don't know where the fuck. Get what? Call me.
I season all with that motherfucker.
This nigga said season all salt. Season all salt. Season salt, nigga.
Season all used to be a brand, though. Season all used to be a brand of seasoning.
Yeah, nah, come on now. That's some old school shit, y'all. Kids don't know about that. You know what I mean? Season all salt.
He said long. He came to the show. It was Larry's, nigga. Man, he said it's season all salt.
That's some, what's that shit? The Mandela effect. No, that motherfucker used to say, on Larry's, that motherfucker used to say season all salt. I'm telling you. Nah, back in the day, that motherfucker said season all salt.
You stuck with it.
So for every one of y'all, if y'all can only choose 3 seasonings for every food that you eat for the rest of your life,
I need season all salt. I need Larry's, whatever y'all want, seasoning salt. I need garlic, and I need some onion powder.
That's 4. Wait, say it.
That's 3. I see seasoning salt, seasoning salt, powder. Garlic powder, and onion powder. That'd be good.
Shit, I'll have to have black pepper, salt,
seasoning salt. This is the way I live. Little boy still pushing big wheels. I stay my money laying low and shit.
Are we just ending the show? Like that? Fuck it. Production said ain't in the show, y'all. We've been talking too long. Hey, episode four too late. Yo, y'all send me. Hey, I want to appreciate y'all motherfuckers for tapping in. This episode four, this episode four, y'all send me. And we here to keep bringing No Cap TV to your goddamn motherfucking noggin. You hear me? And we gonna keep having more and more guests around here. You still, I don't know who gonna be here next week. You feel me? But it's your boy YCM Mac, and I'm here with
it's your boy Hollywood Reek
and my boy
Slim Boy.
Hey, and we out this motherfucker, boy. It's No Cap TV.
Getting in shape, man. I think I'm super M-A-N without a cake, man. Grinding all day, hustling, all for the cake, man. I'm a Benjamin Stack, 1 inch taller than Great Danes. Christy means she bang like a felon. Hey. I'm growing up now, screaming hotter than my winners. Hey. I'm still living good, never gonna fly. Hey, I'm a young little dude, stay running from cops.